Hello everyone, we are from Group 1. First, I want to introduce myself.
Hi,
my name is Chatika, I'm from Class 9. I want to show you about the children, lazy girls.
My name is Ardiana Eka Pratama, I'm from Class 9.
Enjoy watching.
Bye.
A long time ago, in a small village, there lived a beautiful girl named Jenny. She lived with her grandmother, Mbok Sumi. Jenny was beautiful but very lazy. She lived in a very small house because her grandmother was poor. For their living, her grandmother must go to the jungle to find some woods to be sold. One day, the grandmother asked the girl to go with her to the jungle.
Jenny, please come with me to find some woods today. I don't feel well.
No, I don't want to go outside. If I walk to the jungle,
please cook for us. I have prepared all the vegetables in kitchen.
But Jenny did not answer. She went into her bedroom and slept. Not long after that, Mbok Sumi went to the jungle. Jenny just stayed in her bedroom and enjoyed her free time. While she was lying on her bed, suddenly a fairy came to her. She was shocked. The sir shouted,
"Who are you?
Me? You don't want me to know me. Just..."
said the fairy because she suddenly disappeared. Jenny was confused, but then she just ignored her and continued sleeping.
It was late in the afternoon, but Jenny was still in her bedroom. She did not cook until her grandmother came. Mbok Sumi was so hungry after looking for the woods in the jungle. When she wants to eat, there was nothing on the table. Mbok Sumi was very sad. Then she began to call her green doctor. When Mbok Sumi opened the bedroom door, she was surprised to see Jenny become a statue. She was being cursed by the fairy because of her laziness and her bad attitude toward her old grandmother.
Thank you for attention and watch our video.
A lazy girl. A long time ago in a small village, there lived a beautiful girl named Jenny. She lived with her grandmother Mbok Sumi. Jenny was beautiful but very lazy. She lived in a very small house because her grandmother was poor. For their living, her grandmother must go to jungle to find some woods to be sold. One day, the grandmother asked the girl to go with her the jungle.
Jenny, please come and go with me to find some woods today. I don't feel well,
said Mbok Sumi.
No, I don't want to go outside. I want to jungle. I will feel tired. I don't want to,
replied Jenny. Then Mbok Sumi said,
if you don't want to go with me, please cook for us. I have prepared all the breakfast in the kitchen.
But Jenny did not answer. So went in her bedroom and slept. Not long after that, Mbok Sumi went to the jungle. Jenny just stayed in her bedroom and enjoyed her free time. Wilsa was laying on her bed, suddenly a fire come to her, she was scared, then she shouted.
Who are you?
Tiga, dua, satu.
Me? You do not need to know me, I just want to remind you that you have to help your grandmother.
Said the fairy before she shouted this parrot. Jenny was confused, but then she just angered her and continued sleeping. It was late in the afternoon, but Jenny was still in her bedroom. She did not cook until her grandmother came. Mbok Sumi was so hungry after looking for the wolves in the jungle. When she went to eat, there was nothing on the table. Mbok Sumi was very sad. Then she began to call her granddaughter. But no one replied. When Mbok Sumi opened the bedroom door, she was surprised to the Jenny become a startup. She was being cursed by the fairy because of her rising and her bad attitudes toward her old grandmother.
Long time ago in a small village, there lived a beautiful girl named Jenny. She lived with her grandmother, Mbok Sumi. Jenny was beautiful but very lazy. She lived in a very small house because her grandmother was poor. For daily living, her grandmother must go to the jungle to find some wood to be sold. One day, the grandmother asked Jenny to go with her to the jungle.
Jenny, please come and go with me to find some wood today. I don't feel well.
No, I don't want to go outside. If I walk to the jungle, I will feel tired. I don't want to.
Well, if you don't want to go with me, please cook for us. I have prepared all the vegetables in the kitchen.
But Jenny did not answer. She went into her bedroom and slept. Not long after that, Mbok Sumi went to the jungle. Jenny just stayed in her bedroom and enjoyed her free time. While she was lying on her bed, suddenly a fairy came to her. She was shocked. Then she shouted.
Who are you?
Me, you don't need to know me. It just went to me. Need you that you have to help your content.
Said the fairy before the suddenly disappeared. Jenny was confused, but then she just ignored her and continued sleeping. It was late in the afternoon, but Jenny was still in her bedroom. She did not cook until her grandmother came. Mbok Sumi was so hungry after looking for the woods in the jungle. When she wanted to eat, there was nothing on the table. Mbok Sumi was very sad. Then she began to call her granddaughter.
Jenny, oh Jenny.
But none replied. When Mbok Sumi opened the bedroom's door, she was surprised to see Jenny become a statue. She was being cursed by the fairy because of her laziness and her bad attitudes toward her old grandmother.
There lived a beautiful girl named Jenny. She lived with her grandmother, Mbok Sumi. Jenny was beautiful but very lazy. She lived in a very small house because her mother was poor. For their living, her grandmother must go to the jungle to find some wood to be sold. One day, grandmother asked to grill to go with her to the jungle.
Please come and go with me to find some woods today. Feel well.
No, I don't want to go outside. If I walk to the jungle, I will feel tired. I don't want to. Mbak Sumi said,
"Cause Jenny, you are so lazy. Then you have to cook for us. I have prepared all the vegetables in the kitchen."
But Jenny did not answer. She went into her bedroom and slept. Not long after that, Mbak Sumi went to the jungle. Jenny just stayed in bedroom and enjoyed her free time. While she lay on her bed, suddenly and fiery came to her. She was shocked. The shouted,
"Me, you don't need to know me. I just want to remind that you have to help your grandmother."
The fiery before he startling and separated, Jenny was consumed. Put the juice in here and come to sleeping. Late in the afternoon, but Jenny was still in her bedroom. She did not cook until her grandmother came. Mbak Sumi was so hungry after looking for the food in the jungle. When she wanted to eat, there was nothing on table. Mbak Sumi is very sad. Then she began to call her granddaughter.
"Jenny, Jenny!"
Would not reply. When Mbak Sumi opened the bedroom door, she was surprised to see Jenny become a statue. She was being cursed by the fiery because of her laziness and her bad attitude toward the old grandmother.